That's Gary Moore with Murder in the Skies. Now, I always think of Gary Moore as being more bluesy.
Gary Moore enjoyed a very long career. His first period was with Thin Lizzy and as a sort of jazz fusion guy. His later career, when he became almost famous, was as almost a traditional rock blues player. However, he had a great run in the 80s as an unabashed, complete hard rock player. And this is a great example of Gary at his most ferocious. And I particularly picked it because in later interviews, Gary was particularly virulent on the shred guitarist per se. He used to accuse them of playing by numbers and just doing exercises and masqueraded as music. Yet, as that track proved, he could shred with the best of them, and he wasn't scared of doing so.
Is that always the case, the ones, the ex-shredders are always the most critical?
Absolutely, yeah, and probably trying to sort of hide it. I mean, shred guitar, its detractors often call it an immature style of music, and there's no doubt that it brings out the inner young teenager in every single bloke. Or you know, these guys are sort of playing to extremes, and it can sometimes be a quick fix. You know, great big speedy guitar, no restraint, no subtlety. But equally, I mean, great and really exciting, and particularly when you see these guys do it for real in a live situation.
Do you think it's part of a guitarist's development in that you learn to play and then you kind of start to stretch your own boundaries and limits, and that's when you get into shredding and then maybe you pull back a little bit?
That's a great point, and I think a lot of the criticisms of these guys is their musical development stopped when they got to this peak, when they're physically incredibly technically adept, that almost that took over and robbed it of its musicality. And that's definitely a point or an accusation that could be pointed at many of the guys I'm featuring. But again, in any sphere, you have to continue push to the next levels. And I just think there's a joyous element to a lot of these guitarists, and it was a great time.
Okay, I haven't heard of this next band, Owen. Who's this?
This is an LA band called Rat. Rat, again, were very big for a period in the 80s, particularly in the States and Japan, which seems to be the sister country to a lot of these acts. Never really as big over in the UK and Europe, but for your average 40-year-old guy or mid-40s guy in the States, this will take him right back to 1984, cool rock bars, and you know, it was a great example of the hair metal sort of rock scene, and this is a track called Lay It Down.
Yeah.
let's rat and lay it down. A couple of weeks ago, I asked you what hair metal was, and you gave me a sort of brief description then. Can you sort of expand on that a little bit?
Well, hair metal, or sort of, dare I say it, the cock rock guitar scene. This was an era when guys sort of took that glam rock, sort of a androgynous look that guys like Bowie and Mark Bolan and The Sweet used, but maxed it out. You had massive hair, cowboy boots, spandex. A lot of these guys looked more like women than the women did. And it was a big part of the party Sunset Strip LA scene. The mid-80s, again, it was a great time. And Rat were one of the key exponents there, along with Motley Crue, Poison, Bang Tango, Faster Pussycat. And part of the scene that created Guns N' Roses and a number of other long-lasting bands. Rat themselves had their moment in the spotlight, in fact, quite a few years, and actually provided yet another link to this Aussie thing, in that their original guitarist, Jakey Lee, was in Rat. But anyway, a fine example of classic LA 80s guitar style.
OK, well, you're surprising me with a few bands today, because I haven't heard of that one. I haven't heard of the next one either.
Well, this is LA guitar royalty. This is George Lynch, who we'll hear about as well in the next few shows, no doubt. And this is from the band Dokken and a track called In My Dreams that was released, the album was released in November 1985.
In my dreams it's still the same. Your love is strong, it still remains.
So that's Dokken and In My Dreams, and all the way through that track, my brain is screaming, Queen! Queen!
The reason is, it's the harmony vocals. This is an example of their appealing to the average music fan. You've got big lashings harmony vocals, hooks galore, yet also the bit with the solo. Any guitarist from that era listening now will remember that we tended to forward wind, because this was the era of cassettes, of course, to the solo. We didn't want to hear that sort of namby-pamby nice harmony vocals and everything, just hear the real deal soloing. George Lynch was a player who was admired by other guitarists, shredders, as well as general rock players. He had a sort of unique phrasing and a taste to his playing. I think it's almost like the Elder Statesman, even when at this period, he was in his 30s. You know, I think he was born in 54. So he was quite a bit older than a lot of these other guys. And it's a good way of sort of finalising this first programme, the Shred Guitar Scene, as he was not only prominent in the commercial scene, his bands actually wrote songs and stuff, but also in the instrumental shredder, the hardcore scene, the real deal shred players that we're going to be featuring in next week's show.
Can't wait. See you then.
MK Pulse proudly sponsors Seclo Sounds. MK Pulse is Milton Keynes' local magazine, bringing helpful information on food, health, fashion, money, travel, culture and much more to 84,000 people every month. Plus news, views and what's on from around the city. If it's happening in Milton Keynes, it's in MK Pulse and it's available online at www.mkpulse.co.uk. MK Pulse and Seclo Sounds, the heart and soul of the city.